In this video, I'm going to talk about the Ortofon 2M moving magnet cartridges. I'll go over some of the technology they share. I'll also point out the differences as you move up in the line. If you want to read our full review on the 2M series, be sure to click the link in the description that will take you to the full written review on audioadvice.com. Along with this review, you'll find hundreds of other reviews, comparisons, buyer's guides, and much more. Now let's get started. Ortofon invented the moving coil cartridge in 1946 and to this day still make all of their cartridges at their factory in Denmark. This is a testament to their 100-year-plus history of moving the bar forward for great sound. Another mark of success is the large number of turntable brands that choose Ortofon cartridges for their turntables. The 2M series are modestly priced, have plenty of output for most systems, and offer a heck of a lot of value for the money. First, we thought it might be interesting to clue you in on how the name of this series came about. Take a look at this phrase, moving magnet. Do you see the two letter M's? Yes, the 2M series are all moving magnet phono cartridges designed to work with just about any phono preamp. Let's get into some of the technology they share. Back in the heyday of CDs, Ortofon was developing a new technology to allow moving magnet cartridges to have a flatter response at the top end of their range. If you were to chop apart a typical moving magnet cartridge on the end of the system that generates energy, you'd find what are called pole pieces, which then get wired to the connections on the back of the cartridge. Historically, these were tiny hollow cylinders. Ortofon found if you put a tiny slit down the length of the cylinder, it would reduce eddy current losses caused by magnetic hysteresis. This is called split pole pins. That's a lot of tech talk, but the end result is a more flat frequency response with greater extension and more accurate phase between the two channels. All of the 2M models share this tech. Almost all 2M models are made from the same pretty neat polycarbonate material called Hopalex. This is an environmentally friendly material with very high rigidity that is almost resonant free. Using Hopalex means no external resonances will make their way into the sound the cartridge is pulling out of the record grooves. Ortofon designed the output of the 2M series models and the size and weight to be compatible with as many different turntables and amplifiers on the market as possible. This, along with their great sound value for the money, is another reason you'll see 2M models on many different turntables on the market. When your stylus wears out, you'll not have to take the cartridge off, as all of the 2M models have a user-replaceable stylus. This leads into another great feature the 2M models have. The red and the blue have identical generators, and the next two models up, the black and the bronze, have the same generators. The big difference between them is the stylus assembly. You can easily upgrade your sound when it's time to buy a replacement stylus if you have a red by going to a blue stylus, or if you have a bronze by going to a black stylus. This is pretty cool, especially for all of those reds that came with pretty decent turntables like the debut Carbon DC. We should point out that you cannot jump from a red to a bronze or a black as the internal workings are different. Or if you're into mono and 78s, those two cartridges also have interchangeable stylus assemblies. Pretty neat. While most people will use the standard 2M type, Ortofon does offer two other versions of these great cartridges just from a mounting standpoint. There are some vintage turntables out there that require the cartridge to mount from the bottom side of the tone arm. This is called the 2M Verso. If you have a turntable with a bayonet type mount where the entire head shell comes off, you can get any of the 2M models pre-mounted to a specially designed Ortofon head shell, which uses a very non-resonant compound Ortofon developed for the medical industry. This is called the Plug and Play Mark II model. Now let's get into each model. The 2M Red is the first model in the 2M series and is considered by many to be one of the best values in hi-fi. This cartridge is warm, rich, and forgiving, yet it has the ability to extract a lot of information from the record grooves with pretty good dynamics. These characteristics are the main reasons you'll see it as a de facto choice on a lot of turntables in the $300 to $600 price range. If you have a turntable in the sub $500 to $600 range that came with what you feel was a more entry-level cartridge, the 2M will be a great upgrade over most of the giveaway cartridges you see on some entry-level turntables. Feel free to reach out to our experts to see if the 2M would be a good fit for your turntable. Usually, if your turntable has an adjustable counterweight, it's a pretty easy upgrade as the size and shape of all of the 2Ms are very universal. Many of you watching this may have a 2M Red that came on your turntable and wonder about the 2M Blue, the next model up. When you move up to the 2M Blue, it's all about the diamond. If you were to look at a phono cartridge up close, you'll see the round piece coming out of the cartridge body. This is called the cantilever. The diamond stylus, which then traces the grooves of your record, gets mounted to the cantilever. With the 2M Red, the diamond is mounted to a small metal shank, which is then mounted to the cantilever. Starting with the 2M Blue and up, the diamond is mounted directly onto the cantilever, which is called nude mounting. This mounting method reduces tip mass, which means the stylus can respond faster to those tiny changes in the record grooves. You'll hear many more tiny little details in the music, and it will seem more effortless and open. You'll also hear more resolution, so those harmony parts will be better separated, and your music will take on more life, as the 2M Blue definitely steps up the dynamics over the 2M Red. Our advice is if you have a table with a 2M Red, buy the 2M Blue stylus either now or when it's time to replace it. You'll be very surprised at the difference just a nude elliptical stylus can make. When you move up to the 2M Bronze, you'll be taking things to a new level. First, the internal engine is upgraded over the one used in the 2M Red and Blue. The internal wiring also goes from copper to silver-plated copper. The stylus used on the 2M Bronze is a nude fine-line elliptical type. It has a slim profile that allows it to get deeper into the record groove. And as you might imagine, when you reach further down into those grooves, you'll pull out, guess what? More music. If your records are clean, we hear less surface noise with the 2M Bronze as well. The benefit you hear is a much more open sound with a greater level of resolution over the 2M Blue. Many times when you think about components that have more resolution, you may think, well, they may sound a little bright or shrill. This is not the case with the 2M Bronze, which is a very well-balanced sound. The 2M Black has the same engine body and wiring as the 2M Bronze, but with a highly polished Shibata diamond. This type of stylus pulls out even more information from the grooves. As a matter of fact, it's the exact same stylus they use on their high-end Cadenza series of moving coil cartridges. When you compare the Black and the Bronze, you immediately notice the Black just sounds a lot faster and more open. Dynamics jump out at you like we would not believe. On a great recording, you'll think your turntable just got a shot of espresso. The music just comes to life. Just like with the 2M Bronze, if your records are clean, you'll have even less surface noise. Now, there is just one caveat. The 2M Black is very revealing of what is in the grooves. It hides nothing. It also needs to be set up very well from an azimuth standpoint to get the best performance out of it. If you want to stay with a moving magnet and extract every ounce of music you can from the grooves, the 2M Black is a wonderful choice. However, if you're a more casual listener who just loves great involving sound, the 2M Bronze might be a better match for your taste, especially if your tone arm is not very adjustable. The people who make Ortofon cartridges do not want to leave any type of vinyl lover behind, so they even make some special application models for 78s and vintage or new release mono records. The 2M Mono uses a nude-mounted spherical stylus in what is pretty similar to the body of the Red Blue series with a mono engine. It is a really good choice for listeners who want to hear their mono records the way they were intended to be heard. In 2014, the Beatles released their mono collection, and at the same time, Ortofon introduced the 2M Mono SE as a tribute to this collection. The 2M Mono SE is basically a 2M Black in a white Lexan body and a mono engine. As a special nude-mounted Shibata stylus that will guarantee you'll hear every tiny detail present in the re-release. If you collect those shellac 78s, Ortofon has a great cartridge for you with the 2M78. It uses a spherical diamond. This type of stylus is ideal for 78 RPM shellac records, which require a larger stylus profile. You can even interchange the stylus on the regular 2M Mono and the 2M78. You can tell Ortofon is going to make a cartridge for every type of application. And this video only covered the moving magnets. They make a huge variety of moving coils for those of you who want even higher performance. Every time you move up, you'll hear more music from your record grooves, but it is a matter of getting the cartridge that is best matched for your turntable and system. We are here to help you on your vinyl journey with both advice and setup help. We hope our video has helped you understand the differences in the 2M models and that you have learned something about this great Danish company who is now pushing towards their 110th anniversary. If you have any questions on any of the 2M cartridges or any other home audio or home theater gear, be sure to give us a call, chat with one of our experts at audioadvice.com, or stop into one of our Raleigh or Charlotte, North Carolina showrooms. Thanks for watching. If you enjoy this video, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to our channel so you can never miss the latest home audio and home theater content. We'll see you next time.